Our journey to the Scandinavian region of Norway, Finland, and Sweden began in the Norwegian capital of Oslo, which has served as the capital of Norway since 1299. One of our first stops was a visit to the Oslo City Hall, where the Nobel Peace Prize is awarded each year in this auditorium. On a walk around a nearby park, we encountered a young father who explained in very good English how Norway provides for paid parental leave for both parents after the birth of a child, a recognition of the important role that parents play in a child's early development. The historical museum located near our hotel had a fine exhibit of Viking artifacts. We learned that Viking helmets never actually had horns. A site in Oslo not to be missed is the sculpture park, which was designed by Gustav Vigeland and took over 40 years to complete. It contains almost 200 sculptures and art pieces, the most popular of which is the Angry Boy bronze sculpture. It was stolen from the park in 1992 and vandalized in 2021. Another museum not to be missed is the Kon-Tiki Museum, which houses the raft used by Thor Heyerdahl and his crew of five in 1947 to travel from Peru to Polynesia. We left Oslo by motor coach, traveling north through the picturesque countryside, some of which was cold and stark in appearance. Along the way, we traveled through the Lærdal Tunnel, the longest road tunnel in the world, measuring 15 miles in length. We arrived in the Flam region, staying at a hotel that had the best hotel view of the trip. While in the area, we visited the Borgen Stave Church, one of only 28 remaining of the almost 1,000 stave churches originally constructed between 1150 and 1350. These churches were made entirely of wood. Historical graffiti can be seen on one of the exit doors. To get a true sense of everyday life in the area, we visited a sheep farmer and his wife. They live in a quiet, remote area with stunning views. Less than 400 people reside nearby. While we were visiting the area, one member of our group took advantage of the opportunity to get acquainted with the owner's dog. On our way to the seaport town of Bergen on May 17th, which is Constitution Day, we stopped at the Flesher Hotel in Voss for a fabulous noonday buffet. We met the fourth generation owner, all decked out in her costume finery. When we arrived in Bergen, the festivities were in full swing, obviously a day the entire country looks forward to celebrating. Outfits can run into many thousands of dollars and are treasured by their owners. All over Norway, children's parades are a key part of the celebration. We paid a visit to one of the many salmon fish farms that crowd the western coast of Norway. There's a good deal of controversy over the existence of the farms and whether their good is outweighed by the negative impact on the environment. We left Bergen by ship for a six-day cruise along the western coast of Norway. The ship is a working ship, making stops all along the way to deliver supplies and mail. Our first port of call was the city of Ålesund, where we climbed 418 stairs to the top of Mount Ekisia for an almost 300-degree panoramic view of the town and surrounding harbors. The city of Trondheim was founded in 997 and served as the first capital of Norway. The Nidaros Gothic Cathedral was completed in 1320, and it is the burial site of King Olaf II, the patron saint of Norway. One of the more colorful sites in Trondheim were these brightly colored houses. Life aboard ship was relaxing and provided an opportunity to visit, but by far the greatest attribute to traveling through the fjords was the scenery. We passed isolated hamlets, encountered sunsets too stunning to describe, and lazily cruised by snow-covered mountains. The fjords were simply amazing, even at midnight when this video was shot. When we passed by the marker noting that we had entered the Arctic Circle, little did we know what shipboard ritual would be taking place. nothing less than ice cubes and ice water down the back. Even our guide Veronica and her sunflower got into the act. Oh, and did we mention the waterfalls? They were everywhere, in all shapes and sizes. Not surprising for an area that gets over 200 days of rain a year. Another ubiquitous sight in Norway are the trolls. They are beings from Nordic folklore, supposedly living in isolated caves, rocks, and mountains, but are rarely helpful to human beings. Just prior to leaving Norway, we visited a bomb shelter in Kirkenes that the town's inhabitants were forced to use to escape the bombing during World War II. The tunnels are and were cold and wet, giving a sense of what the population here endured. Our first couple of nights in Finland were spent in these cabins off the beaten path, a nice change from the sameness of hotels. We visited a reindeer farm and learned that there are no wild reindeer in Finland. They are all owned. We were able to walk among the females of the herd, including recently born calves. We even took the challenge of trying to lasso a rack of horns on a bench, but our inexperience was all too evident. It was a short plane ride to Helsinki, the capital of Finland. The Helsinki Cathedral dominates Senate Square, and the Uspensky Church likewise dominated the city skyline. Lilac trees were common, and their scent was uplifting in the city environment. Uncommonly beautiful weather brought out the residents to enjoy a day in the sunshine. Our final stop of the trip was in Stockholm, Sweden, where we visited the city hall. 10 million bricks were used in its construction, 7 million of which were handmade. It is elaborately decorated and furnished, which is why the dinner for the Nobel Prize winners each year is held in the Blue Hall. Once the King of Sweden has been served, everyone else must receive their dinner within 8 minutes. One of the most impressive sights we beheld in Stockholm was the 17th century warship Vasa, which sank shortly after it was launched in the year 1628. It lay underwater in the harbor for 333 years until it was salvaged in 1961. Incredibly, the warship is 98% intact from the original. We end this adventure with some random images taken during the 3-week trip.